me hearties, and welcome to the Pirate's Poetry Corner and General Thick and Spot Har. Today I'd like to read for you a poem entitled Freedom is a Noble Thing. It's from a larger work called The Brus by John Barbour. It was written in the 1375 or thereabouts with in Old Scots. Now, Old Scots is what we would call a Northern Middle English, or English, as they might have said. But at any rate, it's about Robert the Brus. But it also covers other topics. So anyway, from The Brus, this is Freedom is a Noble Thing. Here. Freedom is a noble thing. In freedom, all men may have their pleasure. That means they can do as they see fit, right? They can come and go, and they can do with themselves as they see fit. In freedom, all men may have their pleasure. Freedom gives all solace to man. He lives at ease that freely lives. A noble heart may not have ease, or aught else that may him please, if freedom fails. For free pleasure is yearned for above all other things. Free pleasure is yearned for above all other things. Here. He that has nae lived free may not know weal of property. Weal, that's sort of a weird word, isn't it? Weal, W-E-A-L. Weal, it means the good. Right? The good. May not know the good of property. So it's good to have property. It's good to own property, to be in and of yourself free. I'm sorry, I'm digressing from the text here. Let me try that again. He that has nae lived free may not know the weal of property, but rather the anger, nay, the wretched doom that is coupled to foul thraldom. But if he had assayed it, then all by heart he should it wit, and should think freedom more to prize than all the gold in world that is. And should think freedom more to prize than all the gold in world that is. Thus, contrary things, evermore discoverings of the other are. But do you know what that means? That means you learn about freedom from being enthralled. Right? If you're enthralled or enslaved or not free, that's when you understand what freedom really is. It's one of the sort of like a you don't know what you got till it's gone kind of things, you know. You know. And anyway, this whole concept, you know, freedom, we're talking about the 14th century here. You know. And if you go all the way back to the Magna Carta was based on the idea that free men are equal, that all free people should be equals. And freedom is a basic tenet that runs all the way through a lot of this sort of culture that we've got going on here. So anyway, it reminds me of Patrick Henry during the Virginia ratification debates, when he was arguing vociferously against ratification of the Constitution because it left too many things open for human nature to come in and sort of take it little bits by little bits. Anyway, he said, "Guard with jealousy the public liberty. Suspect anyone who approaches that jewel. Anyone." So there you go. A little bit of a discussion about liberty and freedom here in the Pirate's Poetry Corner and General Thinking Spot. I guess we did a little poetry and a little thinking too, didn't we? Well, that's great. And we didn't even talk about rum. Dadgum. Well, maybe next time we'll talk about rum. Because shiver me timbers, oh, I loves me rum. Anyway, so that'd be all for today's Pirate's Poetry Corner and General Thinking Spot. Till next time, fair winds to your sails. Keep your weather eye open and your powder dry.